What do Steve Jobs, Malcolm X, and Jesus of Nazareth all have in common? That's right, they're all dead. I'm only joking, but unfortunately that is actually true. Anyway, what they also have in common is that their contributions greatly shifted the dynamics of the time in which they lived. And my question to you is, do you want to change the world? Now, I don't know who exactly is watching this. Whoever you are, thank you for tuning in. You're an absolute legend. I'm gonna take a stab and say at some point in your life, you've dreamt of doing some real good in the world. I'm gonna take another stab and say at one point or another, you've wanted to be a hero. But what comes to your mind when you think of being a hero or being great? Are you the people's champ like Muhammad Ali? Are you building wells in Africa, or are you simply inspiring the world with your music and your intellect? Now let's get to some harsh truths. Most of us, in fact, pretty much all of us, will never be in any of those positions. Most of us live fairly normal lives. We wake up, we scroll on TikTok, we go to work, we come home, we cry, rinse and repeat. But what if I told you that there is actually a way to make real tangible differences in the world? To solely be responsible for helping save lives, improve education, empowering disadvantaged people, and fighting climate change. You don't have to be a celebrity or an influencer, and you can do all of this from the comfort of your own bed while scrolling through TikTok and trying to get back with your ex. The way to do this, my friends, is called charity. No, hold on, don't leave. I know what you're thinking. This is a waste of time, I already know this, I don't wanna give my money away anyway. But if you bear with me until the end of this video, I'm going to explain to you how you can give to charity in a way that makes real, tangible differences, and how this is actually the best way for you to fulfill your childhood dreams of being a real life superhero. Okay, so charity, I know, it gets a bad rap. Fraudulent, no transparency, no progress. We're also psychologically wired to only really care about what's going on in our immediate vicinity. That's not to say that we don't care about what's going on in some areas of Africa or the Middle East or even in the Ukraine, but the truth is, if we're really being honest with ourselves, we're not carrying that despair around with us on our shoulders day to day. We're more concerned that Kyle didn't text us back. Also, donating money isn't really considered to be that cool. Most people prefer making fat stacks rather than donating them. When's the last time you heard a rapper rap about all the hoes that he provided an education for and helped get out of poverty-stricken neighborhoods? Now, I'm not saying this to make anyone feel guilty. There are heaps of people that do really awesome things within their community to help people, and in my opinion, just being a friendly person is an amazing contribution to the world. But you're not watching this because you just want to put a smile on people's faces. You're watching this because you want to change the world. Now I'm going to tell you how you can get started. There are two exceptional websites. One is called GiveWell and the other is called The Life You Can Save. What these websites do is curate a list of the most effective and resource efficient charities across the entire globe. These charities are independently assessed in terms of their resources, their financials, their procedures, and their overall effectiveness. The charities included in these websites cover medical research, illness prevention, empowering women, fixing the climate, and heaps of other really, really important causes. Now, I know what you're thinking again. You're thinking, damn, Michael, how do you look that sexy in a suit? But you're probably also thinking, thank you, Michael. Now I know where to donate my money, but the problem is I just don't have enough to give. You know, life ain't cheap. Fortunately for everyone, these charities are stringently assessed for their cost effectiveness. With as little as $5, you can provide a bed net to prevent malaria, which kills over 400,000 people in sub-Saharan Africa per year. That means that if you substitute one coffee throughout the week, you are literally replacing that with being a real life superhero. Now I know it's not as sexy as hands-on support or constructing a new library. You won't necessarily individually enjoy the impact of your donation. But I bring you back to the question that I asked at the start of this video. Do you want to change the world, or do you just want to feel like you're changing it? It's actually a pretty confronting question, but answering it honestly is imperative for the average person if they want to make real tangible differences in the world. Many people donate to organizations that hit close to home, and that's completely understandable. If you're a cancer survivor, you're more likely to give to cancer research organizations. If you've struggled with your mental health, you're more likely to donate to a Lifeline or some other mental health organization. Now, I'm definitely not saying to not do this. Any intent to help any cause or any person in need is absolutely something to be admired. But to a certain degree, it's important that we level out giving with our hearts with giving with our brains. The reality is that there are only finite resources, and unfortunately, some organizations aren't really the best at utilizing them. $100 donated to a highly financed organization fighting a well-known cause is far less impactful than donating that $100 to a lesser-known cause that isn't as highly financed. And don't worry, I get it, I understand. Treating people like numbers and statistics feels cold and calculated, and it almost takes the humanity out of giving. But again, I have to ask you the question, do you want to change the world? Or do you want to just feel good because you feel like you're changing it? At the end of the day, it's not for me to tell you where to put your hard-earned cash. And I don't want people feeling guilty. Life can often get in the way of the things that we want to do and the things that we know we should do, and I completely understand that. That being said, there are a few things that I want you to really take away from this video. Firstly, I want you to understand that the single most influential thing that the average person can do to really make a difference in the world is to donate money to charity. I also want you to know where to find these organizations and to encourage you to conduct your own research so that you feel comfortable donating your money and your time. I also want you to know that giving isn't always as sensationalized as you might see in the media. There doesn't have to be statues and celebrations. Sometimes it will just be you in your room being a superhero with no recognition. Also realize that often humans fall into the trap of wanting to feel good about changing the world, and this can get in the way of actually changing the world. The last thing that I want you to take away from this video is to know that you can actually make real, tangible differences. You can be a superhero and you can do all of it without leaving your bedroom. From your bed, you can cure diseases, you can empower people, you can save animals and the planet. It might not feel like it and it might not seem like it, but from your bed, you can change the world. There are helpful links in the description for anyone who wants to do further research. That's pretty much it, guys. I'll see you next time.